You know, I noticed in these interviews I was mentioning before, they would have senators or they would have these owners of these big brands, famous brands. And invariably, at some point in the conversation, they would state a creed. They would couch it as, you know, we believe, and then they would say their creed. And then they would talk about, well, we honor our employees, and they would mention a ritual. And then obviously they had these iconic things that represented their culture and specific words. And it started to be obvious to me that the leaders that we follow and enjoy, they have these pieces either deliberately, but also naturally. They just took the time to deliberately weave this in and to identify them and nail them on a wall, so to speak, and they started to repeat it. And that's the difference between clarity of a brand and a fuzziness of what a brand is.
Yeah, I always call it the fog.
Yeah, the fog. Yeah.
Yeah. And, you know, it's a rhetorical tool, really.
Well, I experienced it. So obviously I wrote a book we're talking about where I talk about you and your primal code in my book. But during the process of writing the book, I took this tornado of ideas that were swirling around in my head for years and started to get it all dumped out and started to become more succinct over time and become organized. And through that book, several of these things started to reveal themselves, and it made it easier for my team to be more clued in to what we believe and why we believe what we do and why our perspective is unique and, you know, where the line in the sand is. It was really cool through that exercise. I've always wondered, what are some of the best ways that you've seen people, they usually exist, but they're not obvious. What is a process that you take teams through to identify it, to help them, like an archaeological a dig, and identify these things, pick them up and dust them off?
Well, yeah, they have to be interesting. The thing that some people do is they, you know, once I lay this down for them, they go, okay, here's my creation story. I've got that. They say, here's my creation story. And they say the creed, and yes, here's what we believe in. And they kind of just spell it out for people. When people don't really care, you have to take these things. It's like the bones. It's the skeleton of the thing. And you have to flesh it out and make it interesting, you know, funny, sad, bring some human emotion to the thing and make it interesting in some way, which however you want to do it, and whatever's appropriate for what you're doing. And then it's not enough just to, because, you know, advise a lot of YouTubers, and it's not enough just to lay it down. Okay, I have it now, and I've made this funny, and I have icons, and I appear on the screen in such and such a way, and all this, and a Revolutionary War outfit, or whatever it is. You then have to continually refresh those things so you don't get boring and dull. That's why things become boring and dull, and you move from being a fad to becoming a one-hit wonder, basically. In the world, we call it, in the music business, they call it a one-hit wonder. In the fashion business, it's a fad. And in real life, it's just dead in the water. You go away. That's why 80, 90% of new products fails, because they either don't do this in the first place and fill in all the blanks, so people just don't understand where they're coming from, and there's no story there. We're meaningless, started out being meaningless, and you wound up being meaningless in the end. So the important thing is to keep them resonant. You have to keep switching them out and so forth. And so someone told me once that they have a chart on the wall with the 7 pieces of code up there, and they just look at the wall and they go, oh, we talked about non-believers last week. Let's talk about our creation story this week. And that's what they do. And then they get on with, this is a quote, the other 36 things I have to do that day. And so that's important to know. And the other thing that's important to know is that some of this, when you read a good story, when you read a good book, when you see a good movie, you can pick out, you know, oh, here's where this, Black Panther or any of them, you go through it. And if you're looking for it, you can pick out the creation story and the creed and all of these things. And because they're all there, because those are the things that help make it relevant and resonate for us as people, as an audience. And so we're just really just doing the same thing. Really what I've done is I've gone back and deconstructed brands, successful brands, powerful brands, to see what made them tick. And this is what I came out with. And the important thing is that no one, while people were doing this through gut instinct, hiring smart partners, who also did it through gut and great instinct, and people had enough money to tide them through mistakes and so forth. But you automatically get, trust, vision, sense of values, resonance, relevance, and all the things that big companies spend millions or billions of dollars trying to keep going every year. And you can do it with zero money.
Amazing. amazing, right?
Thanks for watching these golden nuggets. And as a reward, I got another big fat golden nugget just for you. I wrote this book for you to help you get your act together online so you can grow your business better. You're searching, you want to learn. This is a great book. Grab the book, Grow Your Business.